Yo, what is happening, 2K family? 2K Mechanic is coming back at you guys with another banger for NBA 2K25. Now, we have a very interesting and game-breaking revelation in 2K25. And I want to get into it. We're going to talk about rhythm shooting. Now, what is rhythm shooting? Rhythm shooting is basically you using the right stick to follow the tempo and timing of the jump shot that you choose or that you customize in NBA 2K25. Now, I'll be honest with y'all. When I first heard Mike talk about the rhythm shooting, the first thing that came to my head was like, it was going to be too difficult and nobody's going to use it, right? It's going to slow down simple button pressing and things like that. So I wasn't interested. But let me tell you, yesterday I was messing around, as I always do, messing around in the 2K tutorial type stuff and learning the new stuff. And I seen the rhythm shooting. I said, let me try it. So I hit a couple shots with it. I said, okay, let me try it on my player. Took it to my court, hit a couple shots. Then we went to the street, hit a couple shots. I said, okay. My buddy Cole hit me up. He was like, you on? I was like, yeah. So we got into a red game. And I was like, let me try it. And I tell you, I was shooting a lot better than I was previously. Kinda. Like, I was shooting like 52% of rec. So, right now I'm shooting like 48, 49% because I was messing around yesterday and just trying to get a feel for the rhythm shooting. And I was playing against a lot of bots. Like, where have you ever seen shooting guards get bots in the rec? I've never seen that before, but yeah, I had a lot of bots yesterday and I was trying to get my shot off. So my shooting percentage kind of tinkered a little bit. But I will say, when I went to, I played a few 3v3 Pro-Am games. It was chicken there. And I went to the park. And park was definitely chicken for me. So, I'm going to give you guys 5 reasons why you should think about considering, master rhythm shooting in NBA 2K25. Let's get into it, y'all. Number one, it can definitely boost your shooting percentages. Because I know most of us are shooting in the 40s. And if you're really good, you're shooting in the 50s. And if you're elite, you're probably shooting like 59, 60%. So to help combat us shooting low and us just timing with the button, I think you should probably give rhythm shooting a try. I recommended to some of the fellas yesterday. They were shooting with it and they was like, hey, I could really possibly shoot with this if I lab it up. So I'm not saying you should go right off the bat and start shooting with it. I would say go to my court, practice a little bit. Do on street ball master a little bit, because the difference is in my court there's not latency. I'm not saying there's a whole bunch of latency in street ball, but you got to get used to people contesting you or closing out and getting your rhythm and timing and really kind of getting that muscle memory down. So yeah, that's number one. It could definitely boost your shot percentages, and it's also kind of depending on which mode you're playing. I'll get into that a little bit later. Number two, it allows you to shoot when you're contested. Right. Fortunately for us in NBA 2K25, we don't have a variable shot timing, meaning our shots don't speed up and slow down depending on the contest. If you shoot in your natural rhythm of your jumper, depending on which jump shot you have, you can steal green, especially rhythm shooter. Right. Because normally we have the tendency to speed up when somebody's closing out. We just kind of been conditioned that way in the past 2Ks. But in this 2K, if somebody is contesting you, because the contest system is a lot different, and I'll get into that in another video, but the contest system is a lot different if they're not totally on you. And 2K's kind of patched this in the past few days, but if they're not totally on you, then you can still green it. And rhythm shooting allows you to green even when you contest it, because it keeps the same rhythm and timing of your natural jump shot and it doesn't change that. So that's number two. Number three, you can use rhythm shooting from any shot, right? The only shot I have a problem with is moving fades. I haven't learned how to do it with moving fades, but every other shot you could definitely use it. You know, your post, if you work out of the post, if you're doing hop backs, step backs, or side steps and things like that, rhythm shooting is fantastic for it. And if you can see on the screen, I have it where Mike said you could use rhythm shooting and move it in any direction. So if I start, say for instance, I do a little sidestep, holding left on the right stick, and then I can shoot out of it, or you can cancel out of it, which we'll get into another video. You can shoot out of it from going left to right, right to left, up to down, down and up. Rhythm shooting will activate as it will, the system will record it as a rhythm shot versus a normal shot. So that takes some getting used to, but you can definitely shoot off any shot with rhythm shooter. All right. So number four, a lot of you guys, if you feel like your timing is off, like for instance, you get a bad catch animation or you get a gather step, right? Rhythm shooting will allow you to kind of adjust instead of using a button, right? So if I get a bad catch and I'm using a button, then my timing already gonna be off. And you guys already know in 2K25, if your timing is even remotely slightly off, then you're gonna get a slightly early or a slightly late. It is guaranteed. I've experienced it, everybody's experienced it. Rhythm shooting allows you to kind of adjust your shot because you're holding down, and when you get into your shooting motion, then as you get to your release, then you can release it. So it doesn't necessarily affect your shot timing. The only thing it may affect is your tempo. And like I said, once you get used to doing it a lot, then you can kind of keep your tempo consistent. So that is one thing to kind of lab and learn, that your timing, if your timing is off, then you can correct. Also, in conjunction with that, if you feel like you're really off, then you can just switch to right stick and let it go and flick it, right? Because you know you can shoot with your right stick, you hold it down and then you flick it, or you hold it down, not even a flick, you hold it down and let it return to center to time your shot. So if you're off, you just hold, you feel like you've been holding it down too long, or your shot didn't start when you wanted, you can still time your jumper and not get the tempo and just let it go back to, you know, hold it down and let it go, and it'll go back to center and it will register as a normal jump shot. It won't have a tempo timing with it. It'll have a normal jump shot and you can still green that way. So that's a good adjustment using rhythm shooting. All right, the last one, number five, in my opinion, and not, like I said, I only use it for one day and I will continue to use it moving forward. It helps with RNG, right? And for those that don't understand what RNG is, RNG is kind of random number generator. So sometimes you get a lot of random catches, random timings. You know, you might get that the infamous very late from 2K, which is based on, you know, server latency and things like that. So with latency and things, you know, RNG, rhythm shooting can help you with that, right? So I use the same rhythm shooting, rather I'm shooting in park, rather I was shooting in rec, rather I was shooting in 3v3 pro-am, anywhere. My tempo and rhythm is kind of the same. So I wasn't really affected by latency like that, right? Because it's really just going by the rhythm of your shot. Now, in the instance that, you know, you got real bad lag, you know, nothing you can do about that, right? But if it's normal settings, normal conditions, you can definitely green your shot. But that's it for this video. You guys, run this video to 100 likes and I will give you a detailed video on how to master rhythm shooting in all the different applications. I'll go to my court and show you how you can really get busy with it and how it works and all the details of it. And that won't be my next video, but it'll be a video this week. If you guys run this video 200 likes, I will get you the video tomorrow. 2K Mechanics signing out. Appreciate you guys for listening and watching, and we back, y'all. And also check out the live stream later today. I'm trying to do at least 3 or 4 live streams in a week, so I'm gonna start that off today. So come through to the live stream today and I'll show you the rhythm shooting and all the other things and show you my build and stuff like that. Other than that, I will have videos going to all those details in subsequent days. 2K Mechanics signing out. I love y'all. Have a great day. Peace.